What's up, everyone? Lucas here. Welcome to my channel where I like to talk about digital security and your online privacy. So today I want to talk about something that I brought up quite a bit in my other videos, which are VPNs. Now, VPNs are a really cool tool that can help you as a user in a bunch of ways, from protecting your data to helping you work from anywhere in the world. So, I mean, whether you've never heard of VPNs before, or if you've heard of them but never tried one, this is the video for you. Let's talk about what a VPN is exactly and how it can work for you, especially in a business setting. All right, so first up, what does VPN even actually mean? Well, VPN is short for Virtual Private Network. And basically, at its core, the VPN offers users a secure connection to the internet. And so it does this by encrypting your data. Now, the VPN technology itself has been around for quite a long time, but it's really taken off in the past few years. And whether that comes from companies becoming more concerned about protecting their data or the amount of people who want to access Netflix in another country, we may never know. But it's here and it's really useful. So here we are. Now, first of all, some background information for you guys. There are two main types of VPNs. VPNs for companies and VPNs for individual consumers. And the VPN for companies is also sometimes called a remote access VPN. So the corporate VPN is different from your average consumer VPN because the remote access VPN allows an individual to connect to a private corporate intranet securely while being off-site. And so your company would keep this VPN secure through a password and some type of two-factor authentication. This is basically the tech that lets you work from home without compromising your company's sensitive data. Now, on the other hand, consumer VPN protects individual users by encrypting the user's data. Think of it like a disguise. So if you use a VPN, then your individual IP address gets funneled through the VPN. And on its way from your computer to whatever network or website you access, your IP address gets disguised. To the public network, it looks like you're operating on the VPN's IP address, not your own. This allows you to use the network anonymously, and it also tricks websites or networks into thinking that you're operating from somewhere else in the world, hence accessing another country's Netflix. Not that I would ever condone such a thing. Anyways, moving on, let's talk about how a VPN helps you when you are working remotely. Okay, so offsite or remote workers still need to be able to access resources on their company's private internal network. And in this case, using an insecure public network could make your company vulnerable. And that's where the VPN comes in. Essentially, when a remote worker is authenticated, he or she connects to the corporate intranet through an encrypted tunnel. So this establishes a private connection over the public internet. And the VPN lets users access a closed system through public networks by acting like a kind of firewall to protect the data on your computer. But you ask, how exactly does a VPN act as a firewall? That's a great question. Well, in the past few years, VPN security protocols have expanded to address a whole bunch of things with different security features. First, VPNs use something called IP security. This is, well, exactly what it sounds like. It secures communications from your computer to the internet through that tunnel that we talked about earlier. Then we have something called layer 2 tunneling protocol. This protocol combines two different techs to encrypt your data. Also, some VPNs have what you call a secure sockets layer, or SSL, and transport layer security, which we also call TSL. Essentially, these guys develop secure internet connections for retailers or service providers. And finally, the oldest VPNs use something called point-to-point tunneling protocol. This is basically the first type of VPN, and it's not quite as secure as some of the newer programs. So that's kind of how VPNs work in a nutshell when it comes to helping you stay secure at work. They form private networks that act as the go-between for your computer and a public network, and provide secure networks to house private company data. And it's also a big part of why you can work from home. So it's pretty sweet. So next time your boss tries to get you to stop working from home, or, you know, anywhere you want, it could be a good time to bring up the corporate VPN. I mean, you could basically be the next Carmen Sandiego sitting on a bench somewhere, computer in hand. Plus, if you're looking to buff up your cybersecurity for work or home, you can also consider additional cybersecurity products that will protect both your computer and your online privacy, like antivirus software or password managers. And so, if you're interested in those things, I do have a video on my top recommendations for cybersecurity products. And I include both my antivirus and password manager pick on that video as well. So I'll leave a link to that in the description, and feel free to check that out if you're looking for an idea of some added ways to improve your cybersecurity for work or for home. But that being said, I do want to hear from you guys. Do you guys use a company VPN? Do you like it? Do you hate it? Or is it something you use to travel to the Bahamas on Tuesday? Let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And now, if you are interested in getting a consumer VPN, my personal favorite would be NordVPN. It's really affordable and super easy to use. So if you are interested in learning about NordVPN, I have an in-depth review that I will link down in the description area below for you to check out. So that's it for today's video. As always, if you found it helpful, please leave me a thumbs up, as that always makes my day. And feel free to subscribe if you want to learn more about online security. Be sure and let me know what topics you guys would like me to talk about next down in the comments, and I look forward to hearing from you about that. I really appreciate you guys watching, and I'm excited to hear what you guys think down in the comments below. All right, later, guys.